Good morning students. Today we are going to see back cross. What do you mean by back cross? Back cross means what? Back cross is nothing but crossing the F1 generation. This is the F1 generation. Crossing the filial generation. Crossing the generation that we have obtained after crossing the dominant and the dwarf plant. We get this one. This is called as F1 generation. The F1 generation, crossing the F1 generation with either the tall plant or the dwarf plant. Crossing the F1 generation with the tall plant or the dwarf plant is called as back cross. Crossing the tall plant with the dwarf or tall or the dwarf, that is called as back cross. Okay, this involves crossing between either one of the parent, either one parent should be present to crossing this back cross, doing this back cross. What are the steps involved? The steps involved is there are two types of back cross. One is called as the dominant back cross and the other is the recessive back cross. In dominant back cross, the F1 generation is crossed with the dominant parent. The F1 generation cross with the dominant parent. When you are crossing the F1 generation with the dominant parent, the answer we are getting is no recessive. The answer is no recessive. What do you mean by that? The dwarf plant is not found in the next generation. No dwarf plant is present all or tall. When we are crossing the recessive parent, when you are crossing the F1 generation with the recessive parent, the answer we are getting is all are in the equal phenotype ratio. They appear in the equal phenotype. That means all are, two are dwarf and two are tall. Two tall and two dwarf. That is the phenotype. Okay. So, here when the F1 generation is crossed with the recessive parent, you are getting tall and the dwarf in the ratio 2:2. This is called as test cross. This is specified as test cross. The recessive back cross is specified as test cross. They might ask you the question, what do you mean by recessive back cross? You have to write the point that when F1 generation cross with the small tt or small parent, dwarf plant parent, the answer, the next generation we get, all the phenotypes are equal. All the phenotypes are equal. That means two tall and two dwarf. So this is called as test cross. This is also called as test cross. The recessive back cross helps us to find the heterozygosity of the individual. Heterozygosity means this thing. So to find whether the tall and the dwarf, two T's are present, one T is different, one T is different. To find the heterozygosity, the recessive back cross is done. So what do you mean by back cross? Back cross is nothing but crossing the F1 with the either of the parent. Either means what? Either the dominant or the recessive. Either the dominant one or the recessive one. So this is of two types. One is the dominant back cross and other is the recessive back cross. In dominant cross, there is no recessive character. There is no short plant as produced. In recessive parent, both are produced in the equal ratio, 2:2. Tall is to dwarf in the ratio 2:2. This is also called as specified as test cross. And this recessive back cross is also helps us to find the heterozygosity of the individual. Heterozygosity is nothing but the whether the plant has got two capital T's or the plant has got one capital T and small t. Next we'll move to test cross. What do you mean by test cross? Test cross is nothing but crossing an individual of the unknown genotype with the homozygous recessive. Homozygous means what? Both are small t's. This is called as homozygous. So crossing an individual of unknown genotype with the homozygous recessive is called as test cross. Or for example, I'll explain you what happened. In Mendel's monohybrid cross, all the plants are tall. Yes, in the F1 generation. In F2, they got the ratio 3:1 and 1:3:1 ratio in F2 generation. What he did is, he concluded that when he self-pollinated this F1 generation, when it is crossed with the same thing, you got 3:1 ratio. When he self-pollinated the dwarf plant is capital TT. When it is self-pollinated with the same dwarf plant, the answer we are getting is all are dwarf. In F3 and F4, all are dwarf because it is crossed only with the short plant. So the answer is dwarf plant. So he concluded the genotype of the homozygous small t, all tall will be capital T or capital T small t from F1 and F2 cannot be predicted. Either you can tell this plant is tall, but you don't know either it has got the small gene present or not. To know either it is in homozygous tall or a heterozygous tall, we are doing this test cross. Okay, so to determine the genotype of the tall plant, this test cross is done. Okay, the test cross is used to identify whether an individual is homozygous or heterozygous. To find whether the individual is homozygous or heterozygous, the test cross is done. Okay, so we are going to do a heterozygous tall cross. Heterozygous tall cross means tall plant when crossed with the dwarf plant, the answer we are getting is two talls and two dwarfs. Both are in the ratio, equal ratio. When you are doing the cross, the tall plant with the dwarf plant, all will be of tall. So to know the heterozygosity, either or homozygosity, heterozygosity and homozygosity, either it is capital TT or small t capital T. So it will be a tall plant. So because one capital T is present, to know whether it is in homozygous or heterozygous, the test cross is done. Test cross is nothing but crossing an individual of unknown genotype. Unknown, you don't know the genotype. What character is present in the genotype? So what do you have to do? You're crossing that with the homozygous recessive. Homozygous recessive means what? Small t. So you're crossing this homozygous recessive. That is called as test cross, is crossing an individual of unknown genotype with the homozygous recessive. Okay, so what Mendel did, he crossed the F2 generation with the F2 generation. We have got in the F2 generation, we have got tall and short plant. What he did it, he self-pollinated the short with the short itself. The short was done with the short itself in F3 and F4. All are dwarf plants. So he concluded that when it is there is no dominant plant, it is only the dwarf plant. So to find the heterozygosity, either it is a capital T or capital T small t, we are doing this test cross. Test cross is fine. It helps us to use to identify whether the individual is homozygous or heterozygous for the dominant character. So test cross is done to find the heterozygous or the homozygous of the character. Thank you.